got me thinking of all the things that fathers or whoever raised you, for that matter, whatever they teach you through your life, you think about it. You don't think about it as it's happening, you think about it afterwards, of course. And so I wrote this for fathers. Papa was a good man, strong as a diamond. Taught me so many things that were straight from the heart. There was a love in his eyes, softer than the moonlight. He had a smile for everyone that was brighter than the stars. Everyone knew me by name. Wasn't anything I could do without my dad knowing. I could try to plead innocent, but he knew my game. He had the strength of a mountain, carried the pride of one too. He always said, don't let them get you down. That's one of them little things between a father and you. My own family, me and my little one took a walk around town. As I held her little hand, she asked about her grandpa, so I told her everything that I carried down. He had the strength of a mountain, carried the pride of one too. He always said, don't take what you don't earn. That's one of them little things between a father and you. He had the strength of a mountain, carried the pride of one too. He always said, you've got to be yourself. That's one of them little things between a father and you. That's one of them little things between a father and you. That's one of them little things between a father and you.
Been a Beatle fan. My father used to sit me down in front of this big giant box speaker, phonograph, stereo. You know the kind. You probably all had them. We all had them. And they would play. He would play the Hey Jude album, you know, the Black album. And this ain't one of them. But I sat there and sang the entire album from like five on.
I'm still singing. This
is called Michelle.
Michelle, my belle, these are words that go together well. My Michelle,
I wasn't into it. A friend was, so we hung out at this bar. And this girl walked in, and I happened to look up, and she was right there looking around for her friends. And I stole a little idea from that, and that's about all that's true to that for this song. It's called Angel.
Bud Lake.
By the way, my mother-in-law found likes to go fishing there.
I'm a Carney guy, but I moved to Bud Lake at 9.
Carney?
Yeah.
I'm from Hillside.
Yeah. You're a Parkway guy. So
yep.
So
which exit are you?
Well,
you're from Jersey?
Sussex County.
Awesome. That's a nice
Rockaway.
Name.
Rockaway.
Where?
Rockaway.
Rockaway. My cousins were from Rockaway. You know the Whittles? They were from Rockaway for years.
Bergen County.
Bergen County. There we go. So we got Jersey in the house, man. This is awesome.
Bye,
so I was in the... You're from heaven. That's where you're from. I worked in Bethlehem, Pennsylvania. Well, actually, I lived in Bethlehem, but I down the street was Hellertown. It's a town called Hellertown and a giant food store. You know, everybody went to giant food stores. It's here for giant food stores. But there was a Star Ledger paper there. And it was amazing to see a Star Ledger in Pennsylvania. So it was a Sunday paper, and they're like that thick. So I sat there for lunch and I read the whole thing. And there was a story about the homeless living under the... That looks good.
Boardwalk.
Right. Homeless living under the boardwalk in Atlantic City. And they had a program of some kind. They were trying to get them reacquainted with their family, to come back, get them out from under the boardwalk, because that's not the safest place you want to live. But a lot of people surprisingly didn't want to go home. Or go on to family, but so I stole this. I keep saying I stole this. I didn't steal nothing. Let's see. I took this guy. This guy. They interviewed this guy, and pretty much this is what he said. It's called Underwood Hotel. So many years. We'll skip that. We'll do the last one. How's that?
Okay. I like the AM radio fade out.
I learned that. Nothing. I'm good. All right. Well, there's no percussive instruments, but Barry, you want to come up and jam with me? This is great.
What are we gonna do?
We're gonna do it from Richie Havens.
Jam from here.
You can jam from there.
Yeah.
All right. It's an A minor.
A minor.
I'll probably screw it up. It's gonna be loud. Okay, it's gonna be loud.
It's called
and,
freedom.
It's called freedom. I was at the field today. I have to tell you a story. I was at the field for the first time today. My friend, I went to charge my phone at the campground, and my friend called me up from Jersey. And he goes, "Where are you?" I said, "Camping. Where am I? You know where I am." He goes, "Where are you from me?" I said, "Where are you?" He goes, "I'm at the monument." I was like, all right, well, I'm a mile and a half from you, so get over here. So he picks me up, and we go out there, and I was amazed at the size of that field.
Oh, yeah.
From standing at the monument, seeing that grass, and just, I saw little people standing. I'm like, wow, this place is huge.
And they made a peace sign. They shaved a peace sign in the grass, and I sat in the middle of it.
So,
and there's a little peace sign in it.
And she sat right in the middle of it, and I got a video of it. So the video's on Facebook.
Freedom, 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 freedom.
Dude, nice wrist. Holy shit.
Kill me.
That's really good.
Kill me.
You know what's another
stick with it.